lost far too many jobs. You can have the best of intentions to serve those in need, but without a robust economy, your hands are tied. Now, starting a business, meeting a payroll, balancing budgets, and growing jobs, these are things that Colorado's next governor should know inside and out. As the owner of Denver's first successful brew pub and the mayor of Colorado's largest city, practical experience in creating jobs, attracting investment, and expanding economic opportunity has been at the core of our record. We have created jobs in our businesses, we've created jobs in Denver, and we will create jobs for the people of Colorado. We believe that government can and must be a catalyst to make sure that economic development brings jobs and helps restore our economy. We want to brand this state so that when people hear the word Colorado, they're going to think of entrepreneurship the same way they think of ski slopes. But if we are going to create a truly sustainable economic engine in Colorado, we also have to make sure we have a stellar system for education. Right now, all over Colorado, school districts are going to four-day school weeks. What kind of a message are we sending? What kind of a message does that send to a business that is considering opening an office in Colorado? Our higher education is equally at risk. Our colleges face the worst financial crisis in their history. We must work together to solve these challenges in education, from preschool all the way through college. It is too important to be divided into factions. Every single economic study, every demographic study shows that there is no better economic indicator, no better way to predict an area's economic vitality than to look at what they invest in higher education. We will find a way to make Colorado a beacon for quality, efficient education. We have faced difficult challenges before. I have faced difficult challenges. I know what it feels like to be laid off. So I can say confidently, with true confidence, that the challenges we face today are not impossible. We can overcome the traditional conflicts and divides that break apart Colorado. We can create jobs for Colorado. We can lead the nation out of this recession. We can all do it while running a positive campaign on the future of Colorado. Campaign, but don't think we're not going to point out the differences. We will point out that no other candidate has run successful small business and managed complicated budgets. We will point out that no other candidate has a record of bringing people together to collaborate and solve challenges like we have. We will point out that we are interested in campaigning on building Colorado up, not tearing people down. My guess is that a lot of you have seen or heard the quote, "'Tis a privilege to live in Colorado." It's true, isn't it? That phrase was chiseled all the way across the entire facade of the old Denver Post building. I remember when I first came to Denver as a geologist, I was always inspired when I walked by that building. Sometime I'd stop and just gaze at it and see that huge inscription. But it was more than a poetic phrase. When the owners of the Post first did it, it was part of a marketing campaign. They knew that if they could attract people to Colorado, they'd be attracting more customers for their papers. More than 100 years later, this is still true. It is a privilege to live in Colorado. So many of the businesses that moved here to Colorado could have run their business from anywhere. But they chose to come to Colorado because this is the best place to work and to live. Now, we've been traveling around the state meeting with small businesses that could have located anywhere. Companies like Loki in Grand Junction, Sprig Toys in Port Collins, Swarwell in Steamboat Springs. These companies could be anywhere, but they chose to be in Colorado. We're running for governor because we think Colorado can be the epicenter of entrepreneurship. We know how to create jobs, we have managed complicated budgets, and we have brought people together. We will bring people together. We will always bring people together to do what's right for Colorado. Now, there's a story that I first started telling when I ran for mayor. I've been telling it a lot this spring. You know, it's about persevering in tough times. When we were first running for mayor and nobody gave us much of a chance, I found this news clipping about a professor of public speaking up in Laramie, Wyoming. She was teaching her class about the importance of using opposites in your speaking. She said, talk about the worst of times, you have to talk about the best of times. You talk about the agony, you have to talk about the ecstasy at the same time. The words gain power by their proximity. They gain emotional power. So she asked her class, what's the opposite of despair? The kid raised her hand and said, joy. She goes, exactly. You want people to feel despair, use joy in the same sense. The words gain power by being together. Then she asked, what's the opposite of woe? And a kid way in the back yells out, giddy up! And that's just what we are going to do. It's time to giddy up. Thank you all very much.